Welcome back. My name is Chris, and in this video, I'm going to be doing a demo for NetSuite. So I'm assuming that you haven't purchased NetSuite yet, and really you're checking it out and you're seeing if it might be the right ERP option for you. So I am going to be walking through some of its core functionalities. If you're looking for something that's more of a tutorial or an in-depth walkthrough, check out one of my other videos where I do really dive into how to use NetSuite. Now, before I actually go into the NetSuite itself, I do want to talk about a few points in regards to NetSuite. First off, it is one of the most popular ERP softwares, especially in the small to mid-market niche. Accounting is really the core functionality of NetSuite and really where it shines. So while it does have many different capabilities, it can do CRM, HR functions, inventory management, many different things. Accounting is definitely its core function and where it's most stable. Also keep in mind that the third-party application ecosystem for NetSuite is very robust. So if there's a function that maybe NetSuite can't do or doesn't do as well, you can always lean on some of those third-party apps to supplement or support the core functionality for NetSuite. And another thing to keep in mind is the fact that NetSuite is the very first cloud-based ERP in the software world. So keep in mind that while some other ERPs have really been transitioning to cloud in the last few years, NetSuite's been on it for decades and is very stable in that realm. So now let's actually get into NetSuite and check out how it looks. All right, so here we are in our home dashboard for NetSuite. And really what we're looking at here is the home base that you're gonna be working with in NetSuite. And in this particular case, what we're looking at is the dashboard for, if we look up here on the top right, I'm Carol Morgan right now, and I'm in the role of the controller, which you can see there. So for this particular role, NetSuite has these pre-made dashboards that are already built. So this didn't even have to be customized. This comes straight out of the box. And what it does is, because every dashboard is customized to the role, it's gonna give you all of these different things that really are gonna assist you in functioning as that role. So in this case, if we're the controller, we're looking at things like these tiles. These are basically shortcuts that allow us to look at the balance sheet, trial balance, income statement, et cetera. And by the way, all of these windows are customizable. You can customize all of this stuff, move the windows around to suit your fancy. If this is too much, you can really consolidate it down to a lesser amount of portlets. And you've got things, if we scroll down here, you've got things like key performance indicators. So it gives you these very visual graphs showing you percentages. Are they up? Are they down? You can see them broken down by period, by amount. Again, you can customize all that, have less columns, more columns, et cetera. We've got KPI meters on the left here. So right now we're looking at sales, but you can select by expenses, payables, et cetera, whatever you want. And as we scroll down here, you can see there's just a huge amount of pre-made portlets and modules that come with NetSuite that allow you to just put your data into NetSuite and you're already able to access these reporting tools and really get the most out of NetSuite. So a lot of functionality there. And one particular portlet I want to draw attention to is this reminders portlet here on the left. So this one's going to show you, again, based on the role you're in. So for the controller, it's showing things that the controller needs to interact with. So we can see sales orders that the controller needs to approve. If I was in the inventory management role, I might have item fulfillments that need to be fulfilled. So that's a great way to just make those roles more efficient by channeling all of these different particles through this reminders portlet. So it's just an ease of seeing them right there and interacting with them, passing them on the line, et cetera. So again, just out of the box, NetSuite comes with a lot of capability that you can interact with. And this is just on your home dashboard. So without really delving further into NetSuite, there's so much that you can utilize from NetSuite. So now to take a look further in, let's say we want to do some basic reporting. Well, we do have here, you can see various reports all listed out here, but without really diving in here, because I'm not trying to do a walkthrough, I just want to show you how some of these things look. I do have a report already pulled up here. So this is a sales by item summary. So this report's as easy as clicking a button and it will generate, again, as long as the information is in NetSuite, it'll pull up this report showing us all the various items that we sell, as well as the item type. So inventory, non-inventory, et cetera, how many have sold, the revenue generated by each. And one of the great things about these reports is we've got all these options here at the bottom to specify the reports by time period. We can also do things like utilizing the fact that NetSuite has a classification system. So for example, when you're talking about items, you can break items down into various classes and really use those as subsets for the items. So which items are performing better, which ones are not performing as well, and really need to be looked into. So for example, if I want to turn this report into something that's really diving into the item classes, I could come down here, I could hit class, refresh the report, and suddenly I have a full breakdown of each item class and how they are performing from a revenue standpoint. So let's check out another type of report. I have sales by sales representative here. So here we can see all the different sales reps that we have, as well as how they've performed in this time period. And I can select whatever time period I want and see how their performance is. But then of course you have reports that are a bit more standard from a financial standpoint, such as here we have the income statement. So a standard income statement, very easy to work with and look at. And every single one of these fields, for example, we can see the sales here, $22 million. If I really wanted to see what's composing that number, I can simply click on it. And that's what's called drilling down into these reports. So here I can see for sales revenue, I see every single line item that is making up that number, that 22 million. So every journal entry, every sale, et cetera, that's composing that figure. So again, NetSuite comes with these reports functioning out of the box and they're very helpful. But let's say you wanted to use something that's a bit more of a robust tool like a saved search. Over here, I have a saved search generated. So in this case, I did a saved search looking at purchase orders over the amount of $2,500. So I was able to generate this list and you can see we've got the purchase order type here. We can see the day that purchase order was approved, as well as the vendor that we were dealing with and the amount. We've got all of these different things generated. I can export this to CSV files if needed. And the saved search capabilities are, again, very robust. Lots of different things you can do with the saved searches. But one additional tool I really want to highlight, which is a newer function in NetSuite and is something that a lot of people don't even know about, is SuiteAnalytics. And really what SuiteAnalytics does is it has a lot of the same capabilities as saved searches, but it's much more visual and there's additional functions you can do with it, such as creating some pretty elaborate graphs as well as pivot tables that you simply cannot do within a standard saved search. So let's take a look at an example of SuiteAnalytics specifically, and you can see here, this is for accounts payable aging. So we're looking at, in this case, a pivot table for AP aging. And you can see things like the vendor here, as well as the sums broken down by days on the top here. And then we have the pivot aspect, which is that we also have the external IDs. In other words, each individual purchase order, not just the vendor, broken down on the left. So you can really break things down, not just by amounts, but you can have amount by location, by date, all up against vendors and then vendors by document numbers. You can really elaborate on these various things that you want to really dig in and get the information that you need to best run your company. So a lot of capability here with SuiteAnalytics. And like I mentioned before, one of the great capabilities of SuiteAnalytics is the visuals, the graphs. So here we have the same AP aging report broken down in a graphical representation. And we can also do the same with a line plot. So all of these things are customizable. You can make any kind of chart that you want and a lot of capability there. Now, one additional aspect that's vital for any organization is the ability to generate new records or transactions. So at any point, no matter where you are in NetSuite, if you go to the top here, we have this little, it's called Create New button, and it will give you a list of things and you can add whatever you want here of other records or transactions that you can generate. So for example, if I click customer here, it'll open a page and give me the ability to fill in and create a new record in NetSuite. And the last thing I want to highlight in this demo is inventory management. So if you're selling goods or you have to deal with warehousing of inventory, then it's very simple in NetSuite. For example, I have in this case an item pulled up here. So this is an item that this company sells, which is an iPad Pro. And you've got all this item information here. But if we scroll down, we have a subset called purchasing and inventory. And here's where we can set the purchase price, the costing method, as well as how the inventory planning is occurring. So in this case, I have it set as reorder point, but maybe I want to switch that to MRP. And within that, I'm now able to put in all the various required information. I can reallocate or adjust inventory amounts in warehouses. If I scroll down here, we've got all our locations along with quantities on hand. So NetSuite provides all the information and the capabilities you need to manage your inventory planning. So that's just a quick demo on how NetSuite functions and what it looks like to interact with. Before I finish this video, I do want to make two particular points. If you are shopping around for an ERP and specifically at NetSuite, I do recommend you check out my video where I talk about how to purchase NetSuite most intelligently and not to be oversold on NetSuite. And secondly, and this is very important, how to choose the best implementation team. You might think that you just need to go with NetSuite itself, or also referred to as NetSuite Professional Services, but there's actually a lot of different implementers and solution providers that are out there and available for your implementation. So check out my video where I really give advice on selecting the correct implementer. And if you found this video helpful, be sure to hit the like button, subscribe if you want to see future videos like this, and let me know in the comments if there's any particular video that you'd like to see. And with that, I'll see you in the next video.